you've been doing morning radio for 20 years now or so, or pushing 20 years.
16.
15 years.
Yes, 16.
Can you give me an idea of what your day looks like? How much sleep are you getting? And I'm just really trying to dig deep into the mindset and what it takes, the level of discipline that somebody has to have to reach success. You're up at what time?
So now that I'm at home, I wake up at 5 o'clock. I used to wake up at 4 when I go into the studio, but now I slide out of bed at 5 and I still take a shower in the morning before I come downstairs. I take a shower, throw on my sweats, come downstairs and, you know, set up all my equipment, which is behind me. Yes, on that side, set up my equipment. And then usually like it takes me 30 minutes to take a shower, brush my teeth, come downstairs. And then I come downstairs, I make myself my little espresso or and I set up my show. I have to read like all these notes for front page news because I always present the stories. So I have to make sure I know what I'm talking about. And we start the show at 6 a.m. And then usually after the show, I have a whole bunch of things I'm doing, like meetings, going to this store, you know, Zoom calls, which we have so many of now. But even tomorrow, like I was trying to fit in a meeting, but it's hard because I have like a 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, a 5:30, a 7:30. And so it's been a lot. But what I do try to do is have like one day that's super light where I might just have one thing after work so I could have a little bit of time.
How much sleep do you get per night?
Maybe about, if I'm lucky, 6 hours is great.
Six hours.
I would say on average, maybe about 5 on average, but I try for 6.
And where are you squeezing? Because I know you still do your podcast. So you have
lip service.
Go ahead.
No, I just said lip service.
Yeah, like, you know, and I'm going over in my brain because I love the fact that you started out one way, which is a radio personality, but you branched in. I mean, I'm listening to you. There's real estate. You know, you are in the market and you're starting this investment group. It's the Press Juices. It's the Juices for Life. It's the podcast. I'm trying to figure for anybody. You, number one, have to compartmentalize and make sure I don't make mistakes in any of these different areas. You have to trust people, which is very difficult because most business owners and CEOs, one of the problems that we all have is delegating because we're so used to just getting it done. You've spread in a lot of different areas and they don't necessarily overlap. Is this something that comes natural for you? Is it a discipline in learning to just trust people and that they're going to do a great job? And it doesn't sound like a lot of your entities are not doing well. Outside of the Press Juice, which you said, hey, we're restructuring, it seems like you're doing pretty good in all of them.
I think some of them are so early on, but I think it's good to partner up with people who have different skills that they bring to the table. I know what I'm good at and I know what I need help with. And so if you can find people to work with that actually bring a different set of skills, like maybe it's, I can invest the money and help market, but I need somebody that can handle day-to-day stuff. And you just have to figure out who that person is. You have to figure out who am I going into business as partners with and who am I hiring? Cause that's different too, right? Who do I feel comfortable saying this person is a part owner and they have a percentage, and then who is going to be the person that's the manager that has a salary? Because a lot of times when you start a company, just because you're a part owner, you don't make money. Actually, the manager will make more money than you do at first. And so some people would rather care about the money because they can't afford to invest in a business. And so it's just so many different things you take into consideration, but it's also making sure that you show up because you can't just have a business and never go there and not pay attention to what's going on. So you know, it's important for you to always, and prioritizing, like opening the private label, the hair store in Detroit. Mm-hmm. I was there for like 8 days. I was there every day. We did a little VIP event. It just opened. I'm gonna make sure that I'm there while something's brand new and getting set up. And the juice bar runs pretty smooth on its own. So I don't really need to be there like that because it's been open for 4 years, you know?
Wonderful. Okay, I know you have a meeting after this. Where can, I mean, it's a pretty obvious question, but where can everybody find you?
On Instagram and Twitter at Angela Yee. Also, I have my Facebook, and I would be remiss not to mention that I also have a show on Facebook that I did that they actually helped me do, and it's called Mastery of Comedy. So I created it and I produced it with my girl, Ricky Hughes, and she has a company called Magic Lemonade. And we took four established comedians, Donnell Rawlings, Ida Rodriguez, Carlos Miller, and Roy Wood Jr., and we paired them up with four up-and-coming comics to mentor them. And it's really amazing and funny and really beneficial, and everybody enjoyed it. So we did film that. And so that's going to be starting in, I think, like a week and a half on Facebook. So I'll make sure I keep people updated on that. So Facebook also was the whole point of what I was saying.
Yeah, you got a lot going on, girl. Congratulations. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
I know you got to run. So all I can say is continued success. I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud of the woman you have grown into, the business person you have grown into. Keep inspiring not just young women out there, but older women and men. I think you're a great role model, because so often people get successful, they lose sight of who they are. And I can honestly say your calm demeanor, you know, you're very approachable. You just are a great role model for our community, and you are a true power move maker. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Shawn Prez. And I just want to say I was very flattered that you even asked me to do this. So I appreciate you.
What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.